Listen.
All right, first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take his hips off. Got that off. Pull the hips off, and we'll use that for something else. This is probably one of the easiest props I ever made. I know a lot of people are making them. I just figured I'd do a tutorial on one. I drilled a 3/8 hole right here, took his hips off, and I'll use them for something different. And what we're gonna do now is we're going to put the wiper motor on. And these little straps is what's going to hold it down. And these are like 7 inches. So let me get that. Try to do it. Just make this a fast tutorial. Alright. Alright, well, I strapped these down 7.5 inch pieces, just screwed it into the board. I don't really think it matters if you go where you center it at. I used a 3/8 hole on this side. This is a 5 inch piece. The screw is 3.5, and it's a 5/16. And I pretty much used a 3/8 drill bit for everything. So I'm gonna stick this on here, get the nut. I'm gonna screw it on real nice and tight. Yeah, baby ain't going nowhere. Okay. Now what I'll do is grab, let me see, a 5/16 nut on this. I'm gonna screw it down in there. I'm gonna put a washer and put this on top of it. Put another washer and put another nut on it. I'll show you what that looks like when I'm done. Okay, so I screwed the lock nut all the way down, probably about 5/8 from the other screw. Putting a washer on this on, put a washer, grab another 5/8 lock nut. Okay, so that's this part of it. You know, that didn't take me that long. It's pretty simple. You know, just screw the motor down, a nut, this and that, and I'll show you the other part today. Okay, now what else I did is I got this L bracket. It's about 2.5. It's L bracket comes up about 2.5 inches tall, and I'll show you what that's for when we get farther along. Okay, now I screwed his arms to this board right here, and I left the screw kind of loose. I didn't tighten it up at all. You see, pretty much I could leave it at this and it'll move back and forward, but we want his head to come and lift up. Now some of the skeletons have like a a little tilt and thing. Some, most of them are different. This one doesn't have one. I could put like a little door hinge or something on there, but what I'm gonna do is cut his neck off and put a spring in there. So that's what I'm gonna do right now. Okay, so what I did was I put the spring in there, loosen these bolts up. And then once I got it in, I put a screw in there so the spring don't slide out or come loose, which it won't. And then I took apart these two screws, stuck the spring. The spring will only go like this far in because there's something blocking it right there. So I loosened these two up, slipped the spring in, tightened it back up. And see, now I have the head movement. Which is perfect. I mean, that was the easiest way I could think about doing it. Okay, now what I did was put these little eye hooks, one in his head. There's a little knot right here. I put it right before the one right before this knot. And then I took a 3/8 drill. Don't drill right on the vertebrae because there's like a little spine right there. But what I did was I drilled in sideways so I could put the string through, and that's where that little bracket that I put in there comes into handy. This way you ain't gotta have it going down his arms or anything. You can just put it right through there, tip his head all the way up as far as you want it to go. When the head comes back up, and then you just tie your knot. And that's literally like the easiest prop to make right so far. Yeah, I just tied it right to the L bracket. You gotta make sure your arm right here is as far back as it's gonna go, because that's where he's gonna lean up. So you gotta set it all the way to the back and then have his head like this. And then that's pretty much how it is. That's the whole prop. And then you hook it up to a power supply and put a wiper motor reducer or whatever on there, so you can change the speed and how you want it to go. And that's pretty much it. All right, now I'm gonna put the eyes in. I'm gonna use a little bit of hot glue. I got a green eye. Alright, I'm gonna do the other one. Alright, got the eyes in there. Looks perfect. Alright, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take some carpet glue, spread it all over his face and head. And I have some Kleenex that I'm going to use. Stick it on there. And then we'll go back over with the carpet glue. Mm-hmm. Okay, so now I'm gonna do the same thing that I just did, all over the whole face, the whole body, the whole arms, just the same exact thing I just did right here, and I'll show you what it looks like when I'm done. I'm not gonna tape the whole thing, because that would be redundant. I'm just gonna do the exact same thing I did, and I'm gonna do the whole body all the way down. Then I'll show you what it looks like when I'm done. Alright, so I just wanted to show you something. I put the glue on, and then I took the tissue paper, crinkled it up, and then I'm gonna move it around a little bit, like this. Give it some holes, and just make it look like torn flesh coming off its face, all in all little parts. Just like that. That way it looks real nasty. Just like that. And then I'll just keep doing that, putting it on. Then I'll keep making little nasty parts. Like this. See, it's gotta look like skin's coming up. So, and I'll just keep doing that through the whole body. I mean, once it's done and you get it painted, and it'll look like all flesh and stuff. Then I'm gonna put some hair on it. But I'll show you. I'm gonna keep doing the same technique throughout the whole thing. Just make sure when you put your tissue paper on that you don't lay it on flat. Just crinkle it up and stick it on there. And then you take the brush and work it around. All right, so what I did is I put the glue on there. I'm just gonna show you this. I just caked the carpet glue in there. Get all up in the creases. Move it around. Make sure you get all the glue in, all inside. Move it around. Make it look like skin. Go like that. And I'm just gonna crinkle it up like this and just stick it right there. Okay, just like that. Then I'm gonna take my toothpick. Just move it out a little bit. Flesh looking there. Just like that, and I'm just gonna keep doing that, and let me do the whole body like that, and then I'll show you. This is a little weird. All right, I'm gonna do the whole body, and then I'll take the camera and do a whole look around and stuff and show you what it looks like when it's done. I'm doing a little, when you want to get skin to hang down. The thing is like when you glue this, unless you dip it in, you're not gonna have any glue on the backside, so it's gonna be look weird when you paint it. So I put it on top here like this, so it gets glue on both sides. And I glue it in real good. And I glue it like that. Then I take this. Then I move this around. And I move it around. This little piece here, little piece there. Oh, let me get it back up there. You know, you just move it around and gotta get the skin coming down, but you gotta, you know, get the back side wet. So I put it on it, I wet it down on the back and then bring it forward. And then once you get it stuck to that, you know, then it looks like skin torn off and, you know, just, I don't know if you can see that or not. Like right here, you can see the skin coming down. Okay. Okay, why the glue was still wet? I put some hair on them, you know, make them look kind of nasty. While the glue was still wet, I put it on there. Just give him some hair so it looks like he's still kind of decayed or whatever. Alright, and just to get the skin all nasty like that, I just take a piece of cotton like that. Obviously, I got a bunch of hair in there, so it's going to be even better. Alright, then I take this. There, and that's going to give you like the skin and nastiness of it all. If you see any Kleenex that's bare, hit it with the carpet glue. And that's what I'm going to do to the whole thing. I'm going to do the whole thing like this. The arm, the hands, this part of the chest. You got to make sure you don't hit the joints because that's the part that's got to move. But I'm going to do like part of the chest. I'm not going to go all the way back because this is kind of gonna be sitting in the grave, so you're not gonna see it. I'm gonna paint it all the same, but I'm not gonna go with the tissue all the way back. I'm gonna do like the arms and then part of the chest. But you gotta make sure that you don't do like where the rope and all that stuff comes through. That way, when it all moves, there's no restriction on it. So I'm gonna do this. Then I'm gonna hit it with some hot glue and have stuff dripping down and see where that takes me. And I'm gonna paint it and listen.